Questions for creatures with forward-seeing imagination by Geneen Marie Haugen, dedicated to Thomas Berry. For billions of years, billions of creatures have made a home on this jeweled planet of water and stone. Wild love affairs, sun and earth, fungi and algae, bacteria and mitochondria, preceded and spawned us. Our ancestral lineage recorded in the original eyes of trilobites, an undulating muscle of jellyfish, an ancient skeletal minerals sketched first in the dark heart of stars. Peering billions of years backward in time, we probe deep space and cosmogenesis, decipher the unfurling story of life, yet barely perceive the future hurtling toward us, even as it's shaped by our ambitious grasping hands and filled with the stuff of human imagination, however impoverished or vast. Billions of creatures already know their perfect place in the cosmic dance, their specific genius expressed in relation to nectar or coral reef, sequoia or hawk. Millions of unlettered species already answer questions we have barely begun to ask. The oldest mystery school apparent in ones who commune without cults, communicate without language, migrate without combustion or without brains or hands, couple with the sun, birthing energy from endlessly streaming photons. What must they think of us? What must they think of us? Hungry ghost, hooked up to plasma TV, gathering faraway food in packages, drinking from bottles of plastic, raising forests for scented tissue and catalogs, slicing our own flesh for pleasure or perfection, pursuing pouring poison into the faultless bodies of children, loading the tender arms of young men and women with bombs and guns, exploding their minds with dismembered bodies of their own kind, before they know how to wallow with a lover of wildflowers, beneath the holy moon and burning eyes of the gods, before they know what genius smolders in them, awaiting fire, before they know how to pluck a columbine and offer cool nectar to the lover's tongue. What must they think of us? Billions of creatures co-arising, fading in and out of the irreversible cosmic symphony. Do they regret living as they must, cued to primal harmonics of tide and storm, phytoplankton and oak, lion and vole? And what of us? In the last green flash of consciousness, before we are swallowed by the great night sea, will we wonder if we have left a wake of ruin or of celebration, an offering of reciprocal magnitude to the billowing imagination and wild cosmic womb from which we first emerged as spark?